Hi, I'm James. Ask me anything. Hydrogen is the first element on the periodic table. It's the lightest, the most abundant, and the oldest element in the universe. Incidentally, hydrogen powers our sun and the stars around us. It's one of the building blocks of life as we know it. Good question. Currently, the cheapest way to produce hydrogen is by steam methane reforming of natural gas. However, natural gas is a hydrocarbon, and using it kind of defeats the purpose of sustainability. That's why we call this grey hydrogen. We could take energy off the grid and use electrolysis to produce it. However, if your grid is powered by natural gases, it's kind of pointless and quite expensive. That's why we call it blue hydrogen. The grey ore is hydrogen produced by electrolysis from natural resources. This is the most expensive way. However, it's the greenest and the most sustainable. It's the best, so we call it green hydrogen. Certainly somewhere near the top. On a good day, about 85% of our electricity comes from renewable resources, from geothermal, wind, and hydro. This puts us near the top, by Norway and Iceland. Total fact. About 99.9% of fine particles are removed from the air travelling through a hydrogen fuel cell. In fact, if you drive a Hyundai Nexo for 1 hour, you'll produce about 26 kgs of clean air. This is enough for 42 adults to breathe for one full hour. There are. You have hydrogen, and you've got oxygen, and you put it together, and you get water. Absolutely not. It's generally accepted the Hindenburg disaster was caused by a buildup of static electricity. The mooring ropes, which were attached to the frame but not the skin of the airship, touched the ground, earthing the frame. This caused a massive difference in electrical potential energy between the frame and the skin, which caused a spark, which caused an explosion, which downed the Hindenburg. We've come a long way since 1937. No. This is not an internal combustion engine. A hydrogen fuel cell converts chemical potential energy to electric energy to kinetic energy, which powers the car. Essentially, this is an electric car that carries its own charger with it. You have to fill the car up with hydrogen, but you don't have to charge the battery. At the moment, you can't. The infrastructure required to refuel your hydrogen vehicle is currently under construction. But some of New Zealand's largest energy, tourism, infrastructure, and transport professionals have joined the New Zealand Hydrogen Association to create one. There are many hydrogen projects currently operating in New Zealand, and there's talk of Tiwai Point being recommissioned for the production of green hydrogen, for our own transport needs, and even for exporting to other countries. Potentially, yes. Hydro runs for 24 hours a day, but during the night there is very little demand for electricity. We could use this time of low demand to produce green hydrogen instead of just releasing the water without capturing its energy, as we currently do. Yes, the first Hyundai hydrogen fuel cell trucks are already in the country. They're part of a New Zealand-based trial for real-world daily logistics operations, one of only a few countries in the world to do so. As well as this, the Hyundai Nexo is also here, and it's a pretty cool car. I'll try and keep this simple. A hydrogen fuel cell consists of two electrodes, a negatively charged anode and a positively charged cathode. As hydrogen gas is processed on the anode side, its positively charged proton is separated from its negatively charged electron. The proton travels through a semi-permeable membrane to the cathode side, but the electron is made to travel through a circuit to be reunited with the proton, which it really wants to do. It's the movement of these electrons which generates the electricity and charges the battery and powers the motor. Simple. Kind of. No, but it is the leader. Hyundai has created the first mass-produced hydrogen fuel cell heavy-duty truck, and it's also the only car manufacturer to have a hydrogen fuel cell truck and an SUV. At the moment, the weight-cost ratio favours larger vehicles. Given the relative weight between a hydrogen fuel cell and an electric battery, larger commercial vehicles become much more efficient over long ranges. But the tech is only getting better, and the gap will only ever close. No. Filling a hydrogen fuel cell truck takes about 20 minutes using a commercial fueling station. About as much time as it would take to fill with diesel. It doesn't. The hydrogen fuel cell reaction is technologically unrelated to that of an H-bomb. To make an H-bomb, you need deuterium-2H or tritium-3H. Very rare materials, not available at your local Repco. As well as this, to make a H-bomb, you'd also need an N-bomb. Yeah, they are. They're made of multi-layered carbon fiber material and subject to international standards. A standard that's literally higher than that used in the aerospace industry. To give you an idea of what that means, the final test of a hydrogen fuel cell is to survive having a 50 caliber bullet fired at it. So yeah, it's pretty strong. Nothing. Hydrogen is lighter than air, so it doesn't pull like petrol or diesel. It'll just disperse and be assimilated back into the atmosphere.